Good evening. It's wonderful to see all of you marvelous, phenomenal women. Tonight, I want to share with you a poem by a phenomenal woman whose name was Maya Angelou. The theme of the pageant tonight is Phenomenal Woman. When I won in 1999, I used her poem. And I'm going to do for you tonight, Phenomenal Woman. Pretty women wonder where my secret lies. I'm not cute or built to suit a fashion model's size. And when I try to tell them, they think I'm telling lies. I say, it's in the reach of my arms. It's in the span of my hips, the stride of my steps, the curl of my lips. I'm a woman, phenomenally, phenomenal woman. That's me. I walk into a room just as cool as you please, and to a man, the fellows stand or fall down on their knees. Then they swarm around me, a hive of honeybees. I say, it's the fire in my eyes and the flash of my teeth, the swing in my waist and the joy in my feet. I'm a woman, phenomenally, a phenomenal woman. That's me. Now, men themselves have wondered what they see in me. They try so much, but they can't touch my inner mystery. And when I try to show them, they say they still can't see. I say, it's the arch of my back, the sun of my smile, the ride of my breast, the grace of my style. I'm a woman, phenomenally. Phenomenal woman, that's me. Now you understand just why my head's not bowed. I don't shout or jump about or try to talk real loud. And when you see me passing, it ought to make you proud. I say, it's in the click of my heels, the palm of my hand, the need of my care. But that's because I'm a woman, phenomenally. A phenomenal woman, that's me. And now I want to introduce to you Mike Korzenewski and the Ms. Mature Irving Golden Girls. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
The joyous urge to smile and say, thank heaven for little girls. For little girls get bigger every day. Thank heaven for little girls. They grow up in the most delightful way. Those little eyes so helpless and appealing someday will flash and send you crashing through the ceiling. Thank heaven for little girls. Thank heaven for them all, no matter where, no matter who. For without them, what would little boys do? Thank heaven, thank heaven for little girls.
My favorite part. Thank heaven for you, and for you too. Oh, Mary, for you, and yes, for you too. Jody and Mary, can I have you? And for you.
Those little eyes so helpless and appealing someday will flash and send you crashing through the ceiling. Thank heaven for little girls. Thank heaven for them all, no matter where, no matter who. For without them, what would little boys do? Thank heaven, thank heaven for little girls.
And grown ones too.
Good evening, everybody. I am Pat Davenport, your pageant coordinator, and welcome to our Miss Mature Irving pageant. I'm so glad you could join us tonight. We're going to celebrate senior women as we have for 32 years, And that's always and everywhere a good thing. We want to dedicate tonight's show to the memory of our beloved Miss Mature Irving, 1998, Ina Muscoff, who unfortunately left us earlier this year, and we miss her. But tonight, we've got wonderful music, good entertainment to celebrate, and have a great evening. To get that started, I need a little help. So please, join me in welcoming from ICTN Television, Kathy Whiteman.
Good evening, everyone. Do I need to tell you how excited I am to be back for the 2014 Ms. Mature Irving? And I am so honored to get to share the stage again this evening with my extremely talented and handsome co-MC, Doug McAllister. We gather tonight for the 32nd time. That's amazing. To honor senior women. That's even more amazing. And I can't think of a better way to spend this evening. Throughout the years, we have talked about phenomenal women. The dictionary defines phenomenal as very remarkable and extraordinary. We have seven wonderful women who truly fit that definition this evening. They're here to demonstrate why they deserve the crown and the title of Ms. Mature Irving 2014. Now, it is not easy preparing to be a contestant in this pageant, but these ladies were more than up to the task. For those who are new to our show, here's how this works this evening. So there are three areas of competition, which are personality, talent, and evening wear. In these competitions, each lady will demonstrate her worthiness to represent you as the new Ms. Mature Irving. They're all very different ladies, but they are all, as you'll see as this evening unfolds, they are all terrific. You're going to have a great time meeting them all. So let's get started, and we'll begin with the personality portion of the show. Each contestant will have 3 minutes to tell you about their lives, experiences, and goals. We're about to see seven living definitions of phenomenal. So let's meet these wonderful ladies right now. Contestant number one. Contestant number one is Molly Kolinowski. This daughter of Texas comes to us from right here in the Dallas area. After raising 5 children, Molly figured she was entitled to have some fun. So now she enjoys meeting people and sharing a joke. She has a unique way of spending the day. Molly says that she whistles all the time, except when she's not singing. She's entering the pageant tonight because she said she wanted to try a new experience. She has a truly positive outlook on life. I thoroughly have enjoyed getting to know her this evening, and I know you will too. Please welcome contestant number one, Molly Kolinowski.
That is me, Molly Kolinowski, 86 years worth. I was born March the 21st, 1928. I was number 6 of 10 children. I lived in Dallas, Texas all my life. I went to Woodrow Wilson High School, graduated in 1945 on a Thursday night. Monday morning, I joined the workforce, worked ever since. I met my husband at the beginning of the war. I chased him until I caught him. And I kept him for 64 wonderful years. He got tired, so he went home 2 years ago, October the 8th of 2012. Well, when he left, I didn't know what to do with myself. So I guess I just started looking around. I decided, hey, I'm gonna try tattoos. I'm not gonna show them to you. I was told by my grandson that I was cool. So, if you think a cool grandma is up to being a Miss Mature Irving, try me.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's contestant number one, Molly Kolanowski. So, it sounds like her grandson got it right. I've got to talk her into showing me one of those tattoos. I tell you what a great start to the night. Please now welcome contestant number two, Pat Barber. Another Texas native, Pat comes to us from the city of Bryce, which is located in the Panhandle. She's dedicated to Irving. She enjoys meeting people and being involved in the community. Pat knows how to have fun in her spare time. She is a shark at a card game, hand and foot, and she enjoys the music of Frank Sinatra. Sounds like somebody out there already knows that. You'll have a great time meeting Pat. Please say howdy to Pat Barber, contestant number two.
I'm Pat Barber. I was born in the Panhandle of Texas, a small community of Bryce, Texas, on January the 27th, 1927. The next thing that happened exciting that year was the Great Depression and the Dust Bowl. I started my first education at a little two-room schoolhouse, three grades in each room. Then we moved to Memphis, Texas during World War II, and I graduated from Memphis High School in 1944. Then I met the sailor home on leave named Speedy Scott, and I decided he was the one. And we were married September the 7th, 1944. We had 36 great years together. Three children, Sandy, John, and Judy. Then the war was over, and we spent the next 3 years at Howard Payne College. Then my husband passed away in January of 1981. 5 years later, I met Walter Barber from here in Irving, and we were married. We had 10 great fun years, and he too passed away. My life, like most everyone else's, was full of hardships and losses, but there was a lot of loving memories and great joys. I belong to the First Baptist Church here in Irving, also to the Red Hats Society, better known as the Frisky Foxy Flowers. And I love to play hand to foot at the Heritage Senior Center. And I do love all of the activities that they have planned for us seniors in our glory days. I have three children. I have four stepchildren. I have 20 grandchildren, 18 great-grandchildren. There's always tomorrow. Thank you so much for letting me share this part of my life with you. And God bless each one of you. And God bless America.
Thank you so much, Pat. That was wonderful. Ladies and gentlemen, that's contestant number two, Pat Barber. Let's meet contestant number three now. And contestant number three is Alice Cobb. Alice is from the small Texas town of Sulphur Springs. Y'all know where that is. She has lived in Irving most of her married life and wants to make people aware of what a great community this is. During rehearsals, the ladies had a nickname for Alice, and that's Hurricane Alice, because of her high energy. Whether it's a grandchild sporting event or a senior center get-together, this dynamic gal brings the same positive spirit and enthusiasm to everything she does. When she isn't busy, and she's busy a lot, she enjoys spending time with her soulmate and husband of 47 years, Bobby, and her family. Please say hello to contestant number 3, Alice Cobb.
I love that introduction. This energetic, crazy, fun-filled lady was born on a snowy day in January in a small East Texas town of Sulphur Springs. I am the oldest of 2 girls. Graduated Sulphur Springs High School. As a freshman, I was asked to play on the varsity tennis team. I played doubles. We won the district championship. I lettered all 4 years in high school and still have that leather letter jacket. During the summer months, I played softball, and that was the sport that I loved. I had the bat, I had the glove, and I had the speed. Catching those fly balls that you all hoped that I would not catch came very easy for me to do. In March of 1966, I met the love of my life, Bobby, and the following year, he and I got married. In 1969, Bobby's job transferred him to the Dallas area. These country bumpkins, we loaded up that truck and we moved to Irving. I have 2 beautiful children, Wendy, who is employed with the Irving Independent School District, and Chris, who is employed by the city of Coppell. I have 4 amazing, spoiled, rotten grandbabies that keep me busy with their school activities and their individual sports. In the early 80s, I had my 10 minutes of fame. I was an extra nurse on the Dallas series when Bobby Ewing was in the hospital. Now that was a blast. The medical profession has been my choice of work for over 35 years. Retirement came to me in 2012, but it only lasted 10 months. Now I work part-time out of my home doing insurance collections for a very busy surgeon. Last year, I became one of those beautiful red hat ladies. I am a frisky, foxy jewel. I want to thank all of you for coming tonight and participating in our program. Phenomenal, enthusiastic, energetic, crazy, and fun-filled. Would love to represent this great city as your Miss Mature. Irving is a great place to live in, grow up in, and to work in. Thank you all. And don't you love our Marines?
Ladies and gentlemen, that is Alice Cobb. Now, don't you want to ask her who spoiled those grandchildren? You want to know, don't you? I do too. So, that's Alice Cobb, everyone, and that brings us to contestant number 4, Trish Patel. Trish is our first Yankee of the evening. She comes to us from Pittsfield, not Pittsburgh, Pittsfield, Massachusetts. Didn't realize there was one. This smiling, positive-minded gal loves helping in her community. Her soulmate and husband, Michael, is her partner through all her adventures. In her spare time, she enjoys golfing, fishing, and taking care of her neighbors. Let's see what this charming lady has to say now. Please give her a phenomenal welcome. It's contestant four, Trish Patel.
It was April 1st, 1949, and a young couple awaited the birth of their first child. It was a boy, and his name was Patrick Lewis. Well, April Fools, meet Patricia Louise. And if you'd asked my parents, they would have told you I was no joke. I was a single mom of two amazing little boys who have long since grown up into fine adults. But before they grew up, and before they realized it wasn't cool to have mom around, I got to coach the Wildcat Little League baseball team. Not because I have any great knowledge of the sport, but because I had a talent for keeping a group of little boys focused and organized for an hour and a half, three times a week and on game day. I have spent the past 25 years with my husband and best friend, Michael. We enjoy all the same things, taking a walk, watching a good movie, playing golf, and fishing. Well, Michael does the fishing. I teach patience. I recently retired from my profession as an insurance agent. I was licensed in two states, Texas and Massachusetts, and I held the designation of CISR. While I was in Massachusetts, I became active in the nonprofit organization Bears on Board. The purpose of this organization was to collect new and 12-inch bears to distribute to our local police, fire, and rescue team to give to children who were experiencing a traumatic situation. Now, I would like to tell you about my journey here tonight. I received an email from Pat Davenport asking me to be a contestant. I had questions. I had concerns. So I met with Pat. Pat, with her usual calming and supportive and encouraging personality, answered my questions, calmed my concerns, and I went home. That evening, while I was in the yard, two of my neighbors came over to visit, Adrian and Gavin Martinez. While we were talking, I said, "Do you have the movie Despicable Me? I need the song Happy." They told me I needed Despicable Me too. They only had Despicable Me. Adrian, the older of the two boys, said, "Why, Trish? What do you need that for?" I said, "Well, I'm going to be in the Miss Mature Irving pageant." Big smile came on his face. He said to me, "I'll come. I'll watch. Besides, you're not done yet, Trish." Gavin, the younger of the two, said, "And I've got your motto. You've got the face, you got the style, you got the dress." If I am fortunate enough to be chosen Mrs. Mature, it will be my great honor and privilege to represent this wonderful city of Irving. To my family and friends and everyone here tonight, God bless, and I'll be back.
Thank you so much, Trish. Putting traumatized kids together with a teddy bear, that is a lovely, lovely idea. Keep up the great work. And now we'll meet another lovely lady, contestant number five, Sylvia Cockerham. Sylvia comes to us from the Sunshine State of Florida, and that's appropriate. She describes herself as an upbeat ambassador, and she loves making other people smile. Now that her three sons are grown, she enjoys internet surfing. Is that Florida influence? I think it might be. And reading. Sylvia loves books. In fact, she loves them so much that she worked as the Barnes & Noble story lady for 6 years. Let's hear more from Sylvia now. Contestant number five, Sylvia Cockerham.
I was born an Army brat. My father was in the service during World War II, and when he was transferred overseas, mother and I went back to her family's farm in near Gurdon, Arkansas. There, for the next 3 years, I was adored by my mother, my grandparents, my great-grandmother, an assortment of cows and chickens, and one cranky old mule. When Daddy was discharged, he eventually became band director in Jacksonville. There, I think I had an idyllic childhood, because I remember friends and activities from church and school with great fondness. But when I was 13, we moved to Shreveport, and it took me a little bit of time to get used to the benefits of the big city. But I ended up marching with my bandmates in the Rose Bowl Parade. And I also got to see live entertainment. Live as in non-computerized. When I graduated and went to college in my sophomore year, I met my great love. And I want you to know we were married for nearly 2 full years. And we are friends to this day, 50 years later. Oh. Well, after graduation and another marriage, I began teaching fifth grade. And in the ensuing years, I had 3 sons. Ooh, that sounds like a sitcom. In the 60s, Michael was born. In the 70s, Tim was born. In the 80s, David was born. In the 90s, menopause. Oh, but as I gained experience in teaching, I also realized I enjoyed teaching Sunday school and Vacation Bible School and Cub Scouts, so it was fun. After retirement, I finished up, or didn't finish, I'm not finished yet, but I culminated my love affair with education by becoming the story lady at Barnes & Noble in Irving Mall. And I was there for over 6 years until it closed. But I'm not done with service yet. I have some terrific ideas I'd love to see implemented. For instance, take the multi-generational after-school program, where kids come in and check their electronic devices at the door, and seniors teach them maybe some of the lost arts, like cursive writing, face-to-face conversation. Oh, goodness. But they would have homework help and fun stuff, too. And snacks. I've got a lot of other ideas like this, too. If you want to know, just ask me. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Sylvia. That is contestant number 5, Sylvia Cockrum, everyone. Now, didn't I tell you that these are some great ladies? Now I would like to introduce to you contestant number 6, Elida O'Binion. Elida sets the record tonight. She is our contestant from furthest away. She comes from the Republic of Liberia on the coast of West Africa. Elida is a Texan now, though, and every now and then you will catch her saying the word y'all. And she even knows to say all y'all when there's more than 3 of us. This creative lady worked in television for a long time as a puppeteer and developer of children's programs and a journalist working on women's issues. She enjoys telling stories, and I'm sure you'll enjoy hearing her story tonight. Please say hello to contestant number 5, Elida O'Binion.
Good evening. I'm Elida Jenkins O'Binion from the Republic of Liberia on the west coast of Africa. In 1946, June 13, a young soldier boy met this black ebony young lady. What happened after and what didn't happen, I am the living evidence. The name Jenkins came into being when I was first brought here. I went back, and now I'm back again. So you see, I am a recycled American. After my elementary and high school, I attended the Booker Washington Industrial Institute, majoring in mass communication. After spending 5 years in Ottawa, Canada, I went back to Africa, Nigeria, where I met my Prince Charming, and the marriage is blessed with 6 bundles of joy. We left Canada in 1971 to Nigeria, where I have my children. I was a working class mother and a civil servant. I produced my children's program, wrote my stories. I produced women's program. When I'm not in the studio, I have other activities. I'm the past president of the Catholic Women Organization, CWO, past president of the Lions International Club, District 404, Nigeria, past president of St. Paul's River District, Dallas, Texas, and currently the vice president of the Booker Washington Alumni Association Southwest Chapter. If I'm lucky enough to be your Miss Mature for the year 2014, I have enough to bring to the table. I'm a very versatile lady, and I think the energy has not gone completely. So, if you vote for me, you have no regrets. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Elida. That is contestant number 6, everyone. We had a really nice time learning more about you, and we'll learn more this evening. Next, I'd love for you to meet our final contestant, contestant number 7, Nancy Ard. Nancy was born in the great city of Memphis, Tennessee. She's always done volunteer work and stayed active in the community, and she really has an interest in helping the elderly. Nancy had 5 children, 17 grandchildren, and 8 great-grandchildren. Nancy, how did you have time to work and get anything else done? Now that she has a little spare time, she wants to pursue some creative interests like painting, ceramics, and crafts. I know that you're eager to meet her, so please welcome contestant number 7, Nancy Ard.
Thank you. Hi, y'all. That's what we say in Tennessee too, y'all, or you all. I come from Memphis, Tennessee, and yes, I have met Elvis. When I was 9 years old, he went to school with my brother and sister, and he was over to our house all the time. I took tap, toe, ballet. I was in the, I was majorette in the parade for Danny Thomas when he bought his property there to build his hospital. I also managed restaurants many, many, many years. I've owned a restaurant. I've owned a feed store. I was a queen mother for the Red Hatters. I belonged to the Lioness, and I was in the Eastern Star. I went on the road for 12 years as a singer. It was very hard work, but it was very rewarding work. I finally quit that when I was saved and became a caregiver and a volunteer. I love to help people. I love people, and I've never met a stranger in my life. If I'm chosen as Miss Mature, I will listen to the elderly about our heritage here in Irving. I will teach the children in our Sunday schools and on the streets about the heritage of Irving. Also, I will follow through with last year's Miss Mature. Thank you all for coming. God bless you, And in this troubled time, God bless America.
Thank you so much, Nancy. Ladies and gentlemen, that's contestant number 7, Nancy Ard. So I'm going to have to ask Nancy before we leave here tonight what the best restaurant in Memphis is. My husband is from Memphis, Tennessee, and he's got his favorites, but I'd sure like to know Nancy's. I have had a wonderful time meeting these ladies, and I can't believe that we're done with this part of our competition. So that concludes the personality portion. And if I can be half as phenomenal as these ladies are, then I think I'll be doing pretty well. The ladies have to get ready now for their talent presentations, but we have a wonderful treat for you while we wait. Now, this lady made some folks laugh till they cried last year, and she is here to do the same thing again. If you were here, tell the person next to you, get ready for the encore performance, the hilarious rendition of Patsy Cline's She's Got You by your reigning Ms. Mature Irving 2013, Virginia Gordon.
I've got your picture that you gave to me, and it's signed with love, just like it used to be. The only thing different, the only thing new, I've got your picture, she's got you. I've got the record that we used to share, and they still sound the same as when you were here. The only thing different, the only thing new, I've got the records, she's got you. I've got your memory, or has it got me? I really don't know, but I know it won't let me be. I've got your class ring that proved you cared, and it still looks the same as when you gave it, dear. The only thing different, the only thing new, I've got these little things, she's got you. I've got your memory, or has it got me? Your class ring that proved you cared, and it still looks the same as when you gave it, dear. The only thing different, the only thing new, I've got these little things, she's got.
Wow, that was great, Virginia. Ladies and gentlemen, our Miss Mature Irving 2013. She has a great time going through the airport at TSA, doesn't she? It's been joy getting to know you over the last year and before, and Virginia will share with us some more of her thoughts a little later on in the evening. But right now, we have some more wonderful entertainment. The ladies are almost ready downstairs, but in the meantime, we have a truly phenomenal woman joining us this evening. This young woman show what her talent, what talent is all about. She vowed, she wowed them with her talent in ballet dancing at the state pageant and took the crown. And I'm sure she'll enchant you too. So here's your Miss Texas 2014. Please welcome Monica Evans. Sorry, Monique. Thank you, Monique. That was lovely. You're Miss Texas 2014. I have to share with you, my son's girlfriend is named Monique, but I always tease her and call her Monica. That's where that comes from. My apologies. Well, the ladies are downstairs. They're preparing for their entertainment for you tonight. We've had these two lovely ladies, so let's get on with it. I know you'll enjoy this portion. So I will turn that over to Kathy, and she will lead you through this portion.
Thank you so much, Doug. Here is how the rest of this works. Each contestant will have 2 minutes and 45 seconds to present her talent. It can be singing, dancing, comedy, a dramatic reading, or any other idea that these fascinating ladies have come up with. I know you're going to enjoy it, so let's get started. Contestant number one loves the great gospel songs, whether it's singing, them, humming them, or whistling them. She was making a joyful noise around the house. Tonight, she'd like to share one of her favorite gospel songs with her soulful rendition of it. Here is contestant number one, Molly Kolonovsky.
One bright morning, when my life is over, I'll fly away to a land on that celestial shore. I'll fly away, I'll fly away. Oh, glory, oh, fly away in the morning when I die. Hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. Just a few more dreary days and then I'll fly away to a land where joys will never cease. I'll fly away, I'll fly away. Oh, glory, I'll fly away in the morning when I die. Hallelujah. by and by, I'll fly away, fly away.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's contestant number one, Molly Kolanowski. Hallelujah, by and by. That was wonderful, Molly. Thank you. That's a great way to start our entertainment presentation. So next, we'll hear from Pat Barber. Pat would like to tell you about some interesting experiences she's had with the supernatural. Now, hearing these stories the first time, we were all riveted to our seats, and you will be too. So get ready for contestant number two, Pat Barber.
Listen, I'm the one everybody's been talking about in town, but let them talk. They know I'm special, they're miffed. My goodness, they say I've got all haughty and uppity since I found out that Time magazine's coming down. They're coming to check out my story, and let me tell you, it's a darn good story. It's a lot better story than the one they put in the paper about all the people who thought they saw Mary Magdalene on the overhead of pass in San Antonio. Why is it a surprise that they're coming to Rockford? I have Jesus right in here on my refrigerator. Now, I don't know how you feel about that, but to me, it makes me so special. Well, I had to come down last Sunday night. My supper didn't do good on my stomach, and I was after buttermilk. I turned on the light, and the first thing I saw was this big brown stain right in the middle of my new Harvest Gold refrigerator that I had just cleaned up. I looked real close, and I couldn't figure it out, and then I looked again. And the stain was in the shape of a face. I thought it was Elvis. But then I looked again. It wasn't Elvis. It was him. It was Jesus. Well, I guess you know where I was next Sunday. And the Sunday is for the next 20 years. I was in that purred pew, right up against that stained glass window of Jesus raising Lazarus from the dead. Well, next Sunday I couldn't go to church. Oh, I was so sick. My head hurt worse than anything I've ever had in my life. It was like I was in a coma. A little after five, my friend brought in some supper. And I guess it helped a little because at 6:02 my headache lifted. And I guess Jesus decided if I couldn't go to his house and see him, he'd come to mine. That's the second time in my life that he's come to me. Well, I've seen Elvis, too. We were digging potatoes last summer. Oh, my Lord, I jerked up this big spud. And if anybody told me that that potato could see the jailhouse rock, I don't believe it. Well, I'm not going to tell Time magazine about Elvis. No, sir, I'm sticking with Jesus because he's on the refrigerator. But I will tell y'all something that I've never never told anyone else. It was really gruesome. Here the other day, I saw Bon Jovi on a potato chip. And he ain't even dead yet.
Well, I tell you what, that was absolutely wonderful, Pat. And since we're in the place of true confessions, I have to tell you now, I saw the Stay Puft Marshmallow Man in a serving of Cool Whip one time. Just saying, that's all. Ladies and gentlemen, that's contestant number two, Pat Barber. Thank you so much, Pat. The talent does not stop there, folks. No, there's more. Contestant number three also believes in taking a comedic view of life. She believes that life is not worth living if you can't laugh about things. Now, she's going to share a story with us tonight about aging and this mysterious old lady she knows. Please say hello to contestant number three, Alice Cobb.
Can you believe what's happened to me? A weird old lady has moved into my house. I didn't invite her in. I don't know where she came from. She's a clever old lady, and I catch a glimpse of her every once in a while when I walk past the mirror. When I want to check my appearance in the mirror, she hogs it all up. She eliminates this gorgeous body and face. That's so rude of her. But you know what? I just shout right at her, and she just shouts right back at me. Food items. I just can't keep them in the house. Especially the stuff that I like, ice cream, cookies, and candy. I suspect she has a real sweet tooth, because you know what? She's packing on the pounds. She better watch it. But to make me think that I'm gaining weight, she's been tampering with my scales. She's pretty annoying, and she's pretty imaginative, because when I'm not home, she gets in my closet, and she alters my clothes where they don't even fit. She's a childish old lady, and she plays really nasty games. She's even made my bed higher, and it's such a challenge for me to get in and out of. She's even took my faucets and my knobs, and she's made them harder to turn. She has even found ways to get in my car and follow me everywhere I go. Just when I think she can't get any meaner, she has proved me wrong. She followed me to have my picture made at the driver's license. And when that shutter clicked, she just jumped right there in front of it. Nobody is going to believe that old lady in that picture is me. Thank you. Thank you.
That is contestant number three, everyone, Alice Cobb. That's really interesting, Alice, because that old lady seems to come to my house, too. I don't know where she's coming from. So contestant number four really enjoys life. She brings a positive outlook to things, and she hopes she can bring a smile to other people's faces. Tonight, she wants to do just that through one of her favorite things to do, and that is dance. What better way to do that than with the Pharrell Williams hit, happy. Trish Patel wants to send a special thanks to her friend that she mentioned earlier, Gavin Martinez, for the choreography. Now get ready to cheer whether you like it or not. Please welcome contestant number 4, Trish Patel. That is so great. Thank you so much, Trish. That makes me want to go back and learn how to do the hand jive again. Doesn't it make you want to do that? That was just wonderful. Thank you so much. A very special lady, contestant number 4, Trish Patel, folks. Now, contestant number 5 has definite opinions about growing older and being a senior. And she brought along a friend to help her talk about it. Here is the character that we all know and love, Maxine. Talking about the silver side of life. Show some love for contestant number 5, Sylvia Cockerham.
Well, she told the truth. I am Maxine. And I was asked to take some time off from my time making Hallmark rich to consider my attitude. Well, I have. I've decided I'm going to keep it. Some people think I'm too crabby, but I just speak my mind. I mean, it's a whole lot better than it was in my younger days when I just said what I thought people expected me to say. My boys are telling me all the time, at your age. Well, now how am I supposed to do that? I've never been this age before. As a matter of fact, I've never been as old as I am right this minute. Oh boy.
Sometimes I feel like my train of thought has left me at the station. My day starts backwards. I wake up tired, and then by bedtime, I'm wide awake. I would love to sleep more, but my dadgum ADHD kicks in, and my thought processes go something like this. One sheep, two sheep, pig, goat. Old MacDonald had a farm.
Let it go. Let it go.
Oh, goodness. I can't let my mind wander. It's too small to be out on its own. Men, have you ever wondered how women's minds work? And I know you have. Well, picture your internet browser with 25 tabs open all the time. Now, I've heard some men say that women ought to come with instructions. Well, what's the point of that? Have you ever known a man to read them? Okay. I have learned so much from my mistakes that I'm planning on making a few more.
Then I'll be a genius.
Is it just me, or does everybody pushing a cart through Walmart experience road rage? Oh, boy, if I could lose weight like I lose glasses, car keys, remotes, I'd put the runway models to shame. But listen, you just have to remember this. You are only young once, but you can be eternal. Finally, I'd like to leave you with a quote from my old friend Abe Lincoln. He said, "Most folks are as happy as they make themselves out to be." Thank you.
Contestant number 5, everyone, Sylvia Cockerham. That Maxine sure does tell it like it is, doesn't she? And I especially like the last words, "be as happy." Yes. So here's another interesting lady, contestant number 6, Elida O'Binion. Elida has sung all her life, and she really enjoys it. Tonight, she'd like to share a favorite song of hers, an oldie but goodie. Singing "You're the Best Thing That Ever Happened to Me" by Gladys Knight and the Pips, please welcome contestant number 6, Elida O'Binion.
I am. that ever happened to me. Well, there have been times when times were hard, but always somehow I made it through. Don't worry about the moment that I've been hurting. There was a moment that I just stopped loving you.
Contestant number six, everyone, Elida O'Banion. That was lovely. The judges are going to have a tough time tonight. I am so glad I am not in you guys' shoes. There's a lot of great talent on our stage this evening, and we have one more contestant to present. Contestant number seven, Nancy Ard. As Nancy mentioned to you earlier, she's had a life filled with music. Her favorite style is country and western, and tonight she'd like to salute one of her favorites, the late, great Patsy Cline, singing I Fall to Pieces. Here's contestant number seven, Nancy Ard. That's contestant number seven, Nancy Ard. I think that Patsy is smiling down from on us right now. Ladies and gentlemen, believe it or not, that concludes the talent competition. We are going to take a 20-minute intermission now. You're invited to the lobby to have some refreshments, so enjoy, and then we'll be back with more of the 32nd annual Ms. Mature Irving pageant.